Live performance has always been at the heart of what you two do, and after 32 years, they're still one of the biggest draws on the planet.
Pushed not to be impressed by what Bono manages and the rest of the band managed to create in that really massive space.
He's utterly unafraid of making a fool of himself and of putting himself out there.
You actually feel quite close to those guys who are on stage.
When we walk on stage, I have heard many people tell me that there's the involuntary actions that people, their hair stands up in the back of their neck. They don't even like the band. The hairs go back up and they want to know why. And I tell them, well, the thing that they don't know, which is it happens to us too.
I think it's when you play live, you kind of discover the songs. It's you know, that's when you're, you know, you find out how good or how great or how not so great a song is. It's when you play it in front of your audience.
Even now when we're putting an album together, I'm always thinking like, well, how's this going to go over live? You know, it's like part of the testing in my head is like, will this song cut it live?
You know, we've spent most of our lives on stage facing our audience, grabbing them by the throat or, you know, biting them or whatever. You know, it's a very physical relationship with our audience. When you see people that have stuck together, who clearly have had their moments of cracking their heads together, particularly myself and Adam, actually, and they see you walk out, it says something that's bigger than maybe the band and the music, and then that makes the music bigger.